gracias. Buenas tardes.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon. I would like to thank the organizers of this event for allowing me to be here and all of you for being here. I would like to clarify that the purpose of this presentation is to take us through a business case. We still don't know whether it is successful or not, but at least I will share an experience with you, which is now presenting its organizational results, which are completely aligned with the corporate strategy. Well, maybe I'm the only one during this Congress who is going to use the concept of shared services. It is not different from facility management, but in Latin America, we use this terminology as a synonym of the management of general services and some back office processes that lie at the basis of organizations, the hardcore. I'm going to present the advantages of a shared services model, and I'm going to talk about the requirements of managing a diverse portfolio. I have divided the presentation, first of all, indicating that there is a reality which may be considered as an opportunity for a competitive service. There is a structure, a process which responds to the purpose and to the need. Then constant measurement and communication, which is related to what Eduardo said a few minutes ago. Evolution as a phase following the stabilization of services. And finally, I would like to leave with you our lessons, the lesson we learned, as something which complements and does not exclude facility management, and something which is adequate for the retail industry. I'm going to talk about this group. This business group is the group Éxito in Colombia, with 650 sales points, 20 logistic headquarters and distribution headquarters, 5 administrative premises, 5 commercial or shopping centers, real estate. And then recently we have acquired other premises in Brazil, Uruguay, Argentina, with 2,600 sales points, logistic headquarters, offices, and shopping centers. So the total reach or service potential is about 3,000 premises that we must take care of. Sales amounting to $33 million, and internal a customer with 7,000 square meters. What kind of problem does a center of shared services solve? First of all, back office with either centralized or decentralized services. We answer questions about a non-redundant services when they are in the decentralized area. When it is in the centralized area, well, we should ask the right questions. We should determine if the model is flexible or not. And in the middle, we have shared services with a client or customer-focused service culture. Try to develop the best practice, but we shouldn't forget two areas. First of all, the focus is the customer, and we try to maximize profits through a decentralized service. But with regards to centralization, a lot of economy scales are obtained, bringing efficiencies. Standardized services, per se, also contribute to the same objective. Then, what is the critical route that we must follow to create a shared service center which responds to the needs of a real estate client? First of all, define the client, who the client is, an internal client, or not. Internal client solves the needs for the final client, and with internal one, we should establish service level agreements in terms of contracts, determining my operational capacity, what I should do in order to respond to the problems I'm going to face. But the agreement has a binding force. Why? Because internal client, when delivering his specifications and when it comes to explaining his problem, he should be very accurate in order to facilitate the operational model so that we can carry out the services required by this client. I carry out the design, then I say with whom I'm going to work, then I establish a structure and define the requirements in terms of IT and technology, and then CapEx aspects. Finally, we determine the cost of the services. Well, I state them rather. There is a devolutionary part in the model, which tells me if I should transfer the costs or if I dilute the operational expenditure so that the back office in a shared service center contributes value, but it also has a cost that has to be managed. After establishing that critical route, we must proof that those profits will be real, and the best way to do so is using indicators. But the service levels should be increased. We should increase productivity. The processes should be as standardized as possible. Right controls should be established. The automation levels should increase, and as I said, controls should be improved. We must reduce the infrastructure and back office costs. We must efficiently integrate new business units when they are acquired, especially in the case of international acquisitions, and then optimum combination of internal and external processes that brings about the synergies. The center of shared services, when we already responded to the philosophical aspects, should be aligned to the corporate and with a corporate strategy and a competitive structure. And the recipe does exist. A shared service model should focus the cost and also control, which is the essence of the business. There are three means to obtain them. One of them is profitability or return with centralization and consolidation. We should be careful with the words in green here on the screen, because if a shared service center is not associated to automation of the processes, then the operational and transactional burden of the operational model will spend a lot in the OPEX, and it won't be too smart when setting priorities for technology innovations. But the internal client challenges us when he says the control cost is quite high, but you should bring also care. Don't forget that I am your internal client, and that I must solve the problems of the final consumer. And for that, you should give me some strategic compensation in terms of service and business value. And the important challenge for a shared service center is that it tries to get the most intelligent balance without forgetting that we're in the middle of a standardization process. Even in an atmosphere of cost and expenditure reduction, we should not forget those things. The increasingly important challenge of the management of shared services is to do this under the guidance of indicators. This is the structure provided by a shared service center, but for practical purposes, I focus on the yellow part. and yellow boxes, but with regards to facility, the others are relevant. Productivity management, then accreditation or visibility of the value contribution made by the center to the organization, an integrated purchase or procurement center to buy goods and services, maintenance that should be predictive, corrective, etc. And then we have what we know as general services, cleaning, and others. Then a service, a management of fixed services that crosses the yellow one and which allows us to trace back. Then something that we can present to the top management about a shared service center. We can see how it dilutes the operational cost compared to the sales or the procurements. 300, you see the number of people again, 3,000 people when we started 2011, today 28 more people for 11.4, which is 0.10 in terms of value at the light of operational cost. With my sales, I'm diluting better than 4 years ago. When the client asked me for flexibility, when he said, understand my business and add value, we started to visit the client and each shop, in each sales point, in each office, and in each logistic and administrative headquarters, we used a checklist mechanism asking the satisfaction level they had. And the result was satisfactory, as you can see here. It is not perfect, but so far the client is satisfied. Indicators in hiring goods and services. I will not go through the detail, but please take a look at the first column on the left. These are the indicators and service level agreement, a survey about perfection of the service, the savings brought about by centralized negotiation, the savings obtained in the year, whether the negotiation plan is complied with of goods and services, if the catalog of materials is properly managed, if billing is efficient, then how much I charge for the activity, and indicators more oriented to productivity, that is, savings per FTE, number of people, the number of items bought through FTE, the number of negotiations, as I said, through FTA. I continue with indicators in compliance with the meetings. When I sit to talk with internal client and we review the contract that we have prepared together some time before, well, we see that the client is satisfied with my ability and flexibility to respond. I'm competitive when compared with other parties on the market, satisfactory with regards to the management of the catalog and other aspects that you can read here, management and negotiation, collections to the subsidiaries. Well, this is good. Considering the regional growth, the purchases we've made, the number of management or activities per FTE, the operational management. This is a model that we have applied in Colombia with high success, with almost 1,000 services that would have cost 860 million, but they only cost 246%. This is an ambulance car full of the team and maintenance equipment with spare parts and following with maintenance, the maintenance service level. The orange column is the target for 2015. We see a gray line which was unsatisfactory to me. We took up a challenge And the perception of the surveys is 90% satisfaction. It is a challenge to which we are responding correctly. When I measure the preventive maintenance productivity, I realize that I have red numbers. Of course, this is a success case. I understand the model in terms of requirements expressed and requirements met, satisfied. Well, perhaps the tasks are being solved, but in terms of prevention and situation of CAPEX, I still have a pending issue. And now, what should we do to evolve? The recipe. Well, I will say that some consulting agencies have helped me, but according to the recipe, after a few years of standardizing and automating in order to standardize the services, there should be a phase of evolution which should fly as a project, and to this end, we must implement an asset management model which allows us to save in the OPEX and maximize the APEX, that allows us to have a more proactive model. And then, if the operational activities are not automated properly, we'll continue to spend money as the organization grows, but the back office cannot grow in the same proportion. I should standardize the operational models as best I can and then absorb all the products and services which are scattered, and that the shared service should take care of. Then establishing solutions, the strategic design in the headquarters and the parent company, but the services carried out decentrally. I should go on measuring and communicating, accrediting the cost using the indicators that I showed before. And finally, learning. What are the lessons derived? It is always important to ask the leading customer or client of the organization, the CEO, what does the center won't define an ROI in terms of projects, get committed to a specific figure, define the a period of time to evolve, set up the service level agreement and the governance principles underlying this. Then, service indicators and cost indicators, we should submit them to the top management so that they analyze the value proposal. Communication and communication services. Communication is fundamental, just like in FM. Skills of people and recognizing publicly the excellence, the results in terms of excellence. It is very important to determine who is to be reported by a leader of a shared services center. Well, they really respond to a need. In the case of the Éxito group, the principal was set up in the financial management unit because it was an issue of profitability at costs. Now we're in a stage of maturity and the service levels are being critical. A key factor, unity in criterion of productivity and IT. If technology does not go hand in hand with the proposals, the service, the shared service center will continue to be an added costed element. So, finally, it is a change management project. Per se, the shared service model is a model of change, because if we don't change, the organization will try to do the same as before, but with a different recipe. Thank you very much.